Who am I going to remove? I don't know if this guy's a friend of my friend. Okay, this guy goes. This guy goes. This guy goes, the Russian. Yeah, I'm a huge noob when it comes to Discord and stuff. So. We are waiting for gLiM to come back. Are there some people alive in the chat, guys? What is going on? I just see three people. Chichonsky typed something, Dojo typed something. Is anybody alive? Mr. Stork. My Discord is open, dude. Voice channels. Okay, okay, let's check this out. Oha.
Hey, let's cut this one.
Hey, it's fine. Как ще научи Discord-а? Супер сапорт, значи.
С колето, да, Дискорда е, затова е чата за геймари. Първо, записваме ли се?
Записваме се, лайв стримваме цялата работа.
Не бе, ама, това е втората за коучинга, така ли?
Да, сега сме за коучинга, реди. Охо, чичонския е българин. Следя чата тук на телефончето.
А, екстра, екстра. Ще да питам... И ми съще да не спамим на български. How do you plan to observe with Kolyo together? Are you going to follow his camera or how are you going to observe online together?
I'm going to trust Kolyo entirely with the observing and I'm just going to talk about the matchup.
Yeah, but technically I'm asking if we, for example, now go in game, are you going to be able to follow my camera as an observer? That only might be possible in a live game, but not in a replay, actually. Only live game.
I see.
You can follow his camera, yeah, live game.
I gotcha. I have no idea how we're going to do it. But we will probably do it at some point.
Yeah, just open replay before the stream so that you test if it works and then open a live game with bots. So that you all again test if it works and how it works.
Gotcha.
Before the stream. Yeah.
Yeah, this is our plan because it's too taxing for one guy to observe and cast at the same time. Sometimes I miss the action, you know, and I like to chill and I like to talk about the game instead of clicking like a madman. If I want to click like a madman, I might as well play the game, you know?
When I'm observing, I feel like playing. I mean, I'm watching the minimap mostly, and I'm following what is happening.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
And the yeah.
Chechonsky in the chat, it's like it's a Chechi from the StarCraft. He's our guy, man. He's our guy,
yeah.
Man. Chechi, I haven't seen you in a while, man. Let's hope Chechi starts to play again. He was a good Terran back in the day. He has mixed games right now. I'm checking his profile. Terran, of course, Platinum. Zerg is Bronze. And the Protoss is Bronze as well.
Let me see the audio on the stream.
Okay, check it out. I don't have music on, so... Oh, gLiM is back. gLiM is back. We gotta get him in there.
Him to come.
Okie dokie. Let's see what he has to say.
I can hear you. Alright.
What's up? I hear him, but he's very quiet for me. Do I have to do something in the Discord?
Right click on the person and there is a volume meter and you can adjust it.
I mean, in the caster cavern, I only see you and me.
Oh, actually, he's not in the cavern. Yep.
So where should I find him?
I don't know. I mean, we have to instruct him. Discord. Caster's cavern.
Mr. Stork, great, great, great. What division are you playing in?
That's him, but he's still...
You're gLiM. Welcome, welcome. You can go into Discord, and there is, in the SAC server, there is a Caster's Cavern. And you click it, and you will join our conversation.
Not general, the other one. He's in general, actually.
Ah, he's in general? Okay, move down a little bit and you will see the Caster's Coven. With me and Scorpion in
doesn't
it.
Doesn't have rights. Let's go to general.
Okay, let's go to general. So I just click general, okay? Where is that? Oh, I see it. Oh, there we go.
Yo, hello.
Hello, gLiM. Congratulations.
Yes, hello. Thank you.
Hey, where are you from, mate?
I'm in the USA. I'm from Colorado.
Colorado. Nice.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
We are both Bulgarians.
Yeah, different parts of the country. He's in the central of the country, the old capital, and I'm by the Black Sea.
Yeah, this is a small country in Europe.
Mm-hmm.
Again, affected by the corona, so... We have something in common.
I think some of my ancestors are from that part of the world.
No worries, mate.
That would be cool. So, Wisdom, please load the last game. On the rest of the games, I simply didn't scout good enough.
This was Eternal Empire was the last one, yes?
Yes.
Okie dokie.
Because I personally do 15 hatch, I mean, extractor trick, 15 hatch, link float, and so on and so forth. From your replays from earlier matches, I learned that one can stay on gas and bending transition.
Do you want me to start it or you want me to make you host?
No. I think you should be host because you're doing the coaching.
Oh, okay.
So you can pause and
make
stuff.
Make me host again. Okay.
Yes. Alrighty.
Okay. So, yeah, I've been practicing this build for this tournament because my ZvZ was suffering. I was trying to do like a 13-12, just an early Ling rush with 13-12, and that wasn't working very well for me. So I started looking at diversifying my options. So I came across this build.
This was actually amazing. I am not familiar with the ZvZ matchup, so this was pretty nice to watch.
So it's an extractor trick. Mm-hmm. I must admit, it's a build that would never exist if Destiny was still playing StarCraft.
A great build against Protosection. I believe I've killed Wisdom with this build in PvZ. Wisdom is a Protoss.
Yeah, I played Protoss.
Okay.
Not seriously, that's why I'm going for casting instead of playing, but you know, I'm kind of like the gatekeeper. If the next generation can kill me, so they can move on, you know.
Okay, so
so some pros and cons. So benefits to this build, you get a faster hatch than your opponent if they're going standard, but you also get a faster pool, and you can also defend against 13-12s. You can defend against all ints with this pretty well.
I see.
Because my main concern is getting cheesed myself. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You're
sacrificing economy just to be on the safe side and have options.
Right, I'm going for a tech choice first.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so the speed is much faster, as I saw. Look, the speed is starting and his pool is not even finished, so... it's much faster. You have like a huge opening some seconds where your links are much faster. And you can surround and kill him.
Wisdom. In a few seconds after this, maybe this is my overlord actually over there. So now go to my camera. What I did is I was checking the creep spread, and this time I realized that it was early hatchery. So I realized it's.
That's a good point. Yeah, the creep spread is fast.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the way for another Zerg to scout it. And this time I scouted, I stayed at home, I defended. But props to you, you have really good spending. Where I went behind was on the spending part.
Mm-hmm. This one, I think you should put the spine crawler right where your Zerglings are. And you should try to wall off with either one evolution with the spine crawler and put queens and links on the other free space. This
actually,
way,
let's gLiM say.
Yes. Yeah.
I would say, okay, so this is assuming you scouted it. You're not going a third base. You're going to go two base roach. You need to build a wall.
Yeah.
With your roach warren, you need to spread creep. I can't ping. Actually, I'm trying to ping.
Nobody can ping. I cannot ping also.
We have to be on everybody's camera and... because the game mode. Okay?
Okay, so just looking at the natural here of your base.
Yeah.
You need to put a... Not all the time on all maps, but on this map in particular, you need to put a creep tumor right where basically my lings are attacking. Right where those two bane lings are morphing.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll allow you to make a Roach Warren and one or two Evo Chambers to wall off. And then what you do is you put your queen there. But that's not really something you can do at this point in the game at 3:30 unless you specifically put your tumor right there first without injecting.
Yeah, right now the tumor is actually on the ramp, so this tumor on the ramp should go where the balings are morphing.
Yeah, I get that. The reason for this is because there is a too wide area possibly on this map, and it is not possible to wall off right away with three buildings, and you need extra creep spread, so it goes further. But I believe, that's the reason why. On the most other maps...
It is difficult on this map, yes. I'm trying to think of a good way to do it. Maybe if you just... I can't ping, so this is hard to explain. Like, you had the right idea with your Roach Warren. Maybe if you just move that spine to wall off that area, and then you close off the ramp with your two queens.
Aha, so between the hatchery and the ramp is the other option.
And then you take your lings and zone out the top area to keep them from attacking the drones.
What is the top area? Between the northern gas and the hatchery.
Yeah, yeah. Between the hatchery and this the flying platform where the overlord usually hides, right next to the rocks.
I checked the stats in external tool. After the fight, we are evenish, but what you did was to make a drone window, to do six drones. So let's roll with the fight and see what happens. And why did you decide, and how do you decide to drone up later on?
Okay, so where is the production tab?
You can press D.
Yes, I see. Okay, so I'm still making lings here now.
I'm floating gas.
We're doing the ling bane dance, so that's kind of... that's always distracting.
Lots of damage being done to both parties.
I know I can't outright kill him. So I have to...
Okay. This is your game sense. So you feel it's not enough what you have, so you go for drones.
I drone up and get a plus one roach timing, yes.
Mm-hmm. I'm ahead and I have a lot of resources right now.
Yeah, you have a lot in the bank.
And now I realize that he is away, so I split my army on two parts and try to pressure.
Okay, this is a bit of an over defense because your queens are not spitting on the hatcheries, so you don't have the larva to produce.
Yeah, this is my first time defending.
It's a good idea to get more than two queens. You wanna start another two queens after your first two queens.
Oh, okay.
If you're gonna hold something.
At which point? Because initially one doesn't have the money.
Immediately once you have the money, it's a problem.
Yeah, I get it. Okay.
Yeah, because you have exactly two queens in the bank right now.
Yeah, I get it. But you this need... is because I didn't spend larva, okay?
Yeah.
You need two for injects, committed strictly for injects. You need two different hotkeys for queens.
Have it. Mm-hmm. In a normal game, but this is not a normal game.
Right.
Why do you so make you the spine in the back?
Make the spines in the back because I thought I was going to get countered. Counter all end.
Some run by.
And actually, I could have did it because I had much more army, but I didn't pressure on because I don't know, I was scared.
I was defending with lings, banelings, yeah, and making a couple more in the back. So basically, when you're defending, when you're making a spine, spines take so much time to finish building. You need to start them in the back, otherwise they're going to get killed before they finish if you do get attacked.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Uh-huh. Yeah, this is a smart decision.
Because if you look at the build time, like compared to like a cannon, like for Protoss, it's the time is so much longer for a spine crawler.
Yeah, you also lose a unit.
Shit, you have one and speed already.
Yeah,
when
did
you start your lair?
I started my lair. Oh, that's a good point. Question. I started my lair, like at the 3 minute mark or 3 minute 30 second mark when I first started attacking you.
Let me see.
Let's go back there.
No, don't go. Wait a second. Wait a second. Sorry. I will tell you exact time.
Oh shoot.
What? Why? It's not visible. All right, I can't tell.
Doesn't matter. The lair is ready. So.
No, it matters. The question is, when do you start the lair?
Okay.
Because
somewhere when he's starting the Roach Warren and the evolution.
Okay. I can give you some perspective. So it was when I had my first 150 gas after making a baneling nest. I built two banelings. And then made a lair.
Okay. So it's actually pretty quick.
Very fast, yes.
So you rush the lair? I see.
And that was with the intention to go for a plus one roach timing.
Mm-hmm.
To counter a mass lane flood.
Good, good.
It's a counter. So the plus one roach timing...
I don't know why this attack didn't work. Did the Balings do a lot? Yeah, the Balings did a lot.
I had many links and they disappeared.
Yeah. Balings did a lot, I saw. So maybe in this position you should kill the Balings first with the roaches and then try to surround.
Yeah, but I had bad micro. Although I have two control groups, I did not micro well. I did not micro that fight.
Yeah, it happens.
I tried, but it was kind of overwhelming. I had the idea to right-click the Banings with the roaches, but the links were already there. The links anyway go headlong first into the fight, so he had good setup. I attacked too late. If I morphed my gas into Banings and counter-pressured, I possibly could have killed him about the 4th minute mark. I don't know.
Did you see what happened? He has speed. His roaches have speed.
The game is lost. The game is now lost.
Yeah.
He's ahead.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And with the speed, his roaches moved on the outskirts of the map, and they get quicker before your roaches home. So yeah.
The roach banding composition is a very clever move. Actually, I haven't seen that meta before. But the thing with it is that. If you try to surround the roaches with links, it doesn't work before Banings.
Yeah, this is a good position for Scorpion. He has a good army here.
No.
Just on the defensive, well, yeah. Otherwise.
Okay, let's talk about that. You do have more army than me at this point. If we look at
how come? So I don't.
No, it just looks bigger.
Ah, crap.
It just looks bigger because you have two. Your army is spread out.
Yeah, I have reinforcements coming. Okay, so I just had more production. Because injects were better earlier. I don't know.
Yeah. Injects and a few workers ahead.
And at this point, we're both mining out.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't have a third, by the time you start mining out, you're basically...
That third base was in the blind. I watched on my OV on the other third that I cancelled earlier, but this one I didn't realize it's there. Now this is the point when I realize, okay, maybe he has a third on the other location, and I try to attack it, and I go headlong into Rogers on the high ground, so...
Mm-hmm.
I actually prefer this third location on this map, just for forward creep spread.
Maybe they kill here.
Yeah, good idea with the links from the back.
Yeah, maybe if they went to the main...
You still have to bypass the couple of spine crawlers on the natural.
Those are spreadlings. I mean, they kill only two. I already... Yeah, I tried to... vision. Did I?
Yeah, you tried. You sent two, they died.
Oh,
then
I saw
you sent
the lair.
Three.
Shit, I hit the lair in my vision with the three links, yes.
Mm-hmm.
But I never watched, I never looked.
Yeah.
Yeah, I tried to scout and I happened to have scouted but didn't look at the scouting information.
Everything's good.
Yeah, I practiced with many aggressive Zergs for this matchup, but for this particular match. But
this opening is awesome, I think.
In ZvZ, it's very good.
Yes, ZvZ is a great matchup. I got frustrated watching you and dying from you, but ZvZ generally is a great matchup.
GG!
On all of the games, I realized that I were overdrawing, so on the last game, I finally scouted so that that the build is this one, so I have to defend, that you're going to have to go at me, so...
That's kind of the problem with playing standard in ZvZ. If your opponent is rushing you, you risk overdroning. But yeah, creep termer at the natural wall to make a wall and hold with a queen and a spine. And then two base drone roach from there.
I don't believe... No, I mean, no. I have also played the style, or I'm saying no and I'm asking a question. So this is the question. I have also played the no link speed roach wall off build. So you basically make only drones and you try to wall off as soon as possible. I believe that your link floods will be here before I wall off, or it will run the wall down. And I like my defense, the thing that I did better. We had a link bane nest, I rushed my bane link nest.
Yes and no. Yes and no. So initially, when you're getting poked by the first six lings, it's just six lings. That's all I can produce at the 3 minute mark. So as long as you... Yeah, from the 2 to 3 minute mark, that's all you're going to get attacked with. So you just need to prepare for those six lings, and then drone and wall from there. The flood will come, but it's not coming till like 3 minutes 30 seconds, 3 minutes 45.
3:40.
By that time, you should be able to make a wall. As long as you tumor first.
Yeah, is this the situation versus other races as well? Yeah, I mean the timing. I'm talking about the timing.
Yeah, the timing is just let me say.
Mm-hmm. So around 3:40, you should expect the link flood to hit.
Let me tell you exactly. His metabolic boost ended at he started metabolic boost. I mean link speed at 2 minutes. 2 minutes, let's say 1:55. How long does it take to complete metabolic boost?
79 seconds. So. Ideally, I should be starting at 1:45, and it should be finishing at 3:05, but it's not. It's finishing at 3:15 or later.
Yeah, and the build wisdom is that we move out from our base with all the Zergings that we have accumulated, because we stay on 16, he stays on 18 drones. We pull off gas against other races, and we go out of the base with 20 and more Zergings, and we flood Zergings. 5 seconds before the link speed is done.
Gotcha.
So this is our timing. 5 seconds before the link speed is done. So we are mid-map when the speed is done and we hit the timing on the protoss wall.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
I don't do that against Terran because Terran has high ground wall, has splash damage, has Helions.
I like doing that against Terran because if they make the tech lab or reactor as part of the wall, you can get in every time.
We actually have Terran in the chat.
I have a question actually, gLiM. Do you do that with the baning nest again? And how many drones do you stop? And do you stay on gas?
Because it's the same exact build.
The same exact build, okay.
18 drones, yep.
I know the gasless version. When you make link speed and pull off gas so that you have a second queen and you...
Okay. There's another variant specifically for Terran. It's the 16 pool, 17 hatch. I think Cyril popularized it. I call it the Cyril 16 pool.
Okay.
So you get.
Yeah.
So you drone to 16 and then you make a pool.
And if the Terran makes their CC on the low ground, you can usually cancel it with the links.
Exactly. It's good for... So your ling speed finishes at 3 minutes flat. It's a 3 minute ling rush. And then you follow it up with... You make five... You make a baneling last once you get to another 100 gas.
How many links... how many drones mine from the gas?
Three. And then you pull one off gas to make a baneling nest.
At 50 gas for the baneling nest?
No, actually you wait till you have 100 gas. That's the timing for that.
So 100 for the ring speed, another 100 for the baning nest.
Way you have 125 gas by the time the baning nest finishes.
For baning busts.
Yeah, for a bust. Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
So we have the Terran here in the chat character.
Yep.
Hello, mate.
Can I demonstrate?
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
What do you guys want to do? Are we going to do some show matches?
Yep.
Alrighty. Pick a map and who is playing?
This is actually map gLiM, is it map specific and spawn specific that you do the banning bust, or you bust anyway?
Because well, you're usually bust in the high ground, not the low ground, so it doesn't matter. Usually,
it's not exactly map specific, but if I spawn on, okay, so the tech lab has to be part of the wall. So if they spawn on the south side or north side or whatever the side it is,
yeah, this is what I'm talking.
Half the time that doesn't happen.
Yeah, half the time that doesn't happen. So yeah, but the idea with them is that you have the depots and the tech lab or the reactor, whatever. Or is it? Does it matter actually, Jim?
I'd say not really, but for me, yes. Just because if I catch the tech lab while it's being produced, they can't repair it while it's building. So if I keep 3 lings on it, it doesn't matter how many lings I lose, as long as I kill that tech lab, I'm in, and that's GG.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, we can see it now. I will leave the chat so I can comment the game on the stream. And
why? What's the problem?
I can only react if I scout the Baneling nodes.
Yeah, otherwise you're doing your standard build.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
If I lose the Reaper...
Okay, are you guys ready? I can start and I will leave the Discord chat. Okay. Have fun. Good luck.
See you later.
How do I leave the chat in general? What do I have to do?
There is a hang up button down below.
Gotcha. Hang up down below. Ah! Excellent. Yeah. Alrighty. Man, we got a game on our hands. Actually, this coaching session is becoming a very, very, very nice show match. In the bottom left, we have heroes, character, spawning as the yellow Terran, and he is walling off. In the top right, we have the elites, gLiM, who was giving advice to our man Scorpion. So, we are going to see amazing ZVT action, guys, babes, ladies and gentlemen, people, cats, dogs, whatever, man. We live in a free world, be whatever you wanna be, just don't, mess with the other people. Character is building his barracks and he's going for his refinery. Scouting SCV on the way. And we have the Overlord coming. Actually, both Overlords are coming. I didn't notice what the build was, but anyway, we have a quick guess and a quick pull right before the expansion for the Zerg. So, character is coming and he's seeing that this guy is late. Or he thinks those guys are almost ready, so... Yeah, what is his tech choice? He has a Reaper on the way. The SCV is... Walking around. Refinery. Ooh! A command center. I like it. So, guys. Character is around 350. 3500 MMR. And the gLiM guy is around 3900, so there is a 400 difference in MMR. I don't know. Usually I'm in the Masters division, and if we have that big of a difference, it's huge, man. I mean, I die flat out. Almost no chance. So, is this the situation? Over here, only one marine defending, but it's quite enough. The supply depots are going to be repaired. We have overlords, they're moving away from the right positions, and this guy is the spotter. He's going to see and he's going to bait some marines to try to kill him. Speed is almost done, we have the bandings almost done, and did he saw it? Let me put the microphone down. Yeah, he saw it. He knows. Yeah, he actually knows, and that's why we have the double bunkers and double command centers up there and ready. So, this attack is going to be very decisive. It's actually a real all-in. Wow, wow, he has only one marine. Dude, where is the army? Move the links back. This is dead. Okay, the links are gone. He has only one marine in the bunker. Two marines. Two marines. Hey, okay, I get it. The wall is thick. But everybody's thick nowadays, man. Not only the wall is thick, but everybody's thick. You know what I'm saying? We have only one on gas. Engineering bay. Oh, huge wall. Thick wall. I like it. That wall is like my dick. As thick as they come. Yeah. This tank, man. The tank is going to kill a lot before it passes to the afterlife. Chichonsky wants to see some battle cruisers in the chat. And broodlords. We never know. We never know. The game is unpredictable now. Eh, he said because he lost a tank. I know, I know. Character lost a tank. Doesn't matter. Actually, the bearings didn't break him and he's a few workers ahead. He has the mules. So, economically speaking, the Terran is ahead. After this tank sieges, everything is fine, ladies and gentlemen. You can salvage the bunker, probably make one here down on the low ground. This is safe. Go for his upgrades, everything is fine. Okay, the bait is working, or is it? No links are coming, but there are no Zerglings able to kill the links. So, usually what I see from pro players is that they use this guy, I mean this overlord here, is coming, and the marines see it, and they try to get out, get out and kill it. And the links are waiting here or here with speed, and when the marines overextend, the Zerglings surround them and they kill them. Welcome to the jungle. Sneaky, sneaky, the scan sees it. Oh, the scan saw it, man. I am absolutely 150% sure. Queens transfuse the... Oh yes! Amazing transfuse! Right on the Nida Swarm. Bandings are coming. He can snipe them. He can snipe them. Great micro from the Terran. Character! Doing work. This tank man is going to be a hero. This tank over here. Nothing will pass. Oh, of course, man. Feed the tank. Feed the tank. He has a couple of medivacs. 15 workers die. If the medivacs were in play, it's not going to happen that easy. This tankman again. This is the hero. 19 kills. 22. And rising. 25. Every volley and a GG. Okay, okay, he taps. I like it. I like it. I take it. A great follow-up. Alrighty. Do you want to see me play or something? Some Zerg versus Protoss action. Boom. Okay, guys, we're going. We have more observers coming! Welcome, welcome. Check it out. Follow if you like it. And we can go. So I'm not going to talk because the microphone. Okay, I can talk, I think. We will see. gLiM is ready. I am ready. But I want to start some music because I cannot play without this shit. So we're having this. What am I going to do with this guy?
Good luck, have fun.
Okay, basically war first. Let's get it, guys, let's get it. Ooh, first game for the day. I'm nervous already. Let's get him. Do we have the spawning pool? Spawning pool, not only the spawning pool, but a gas. Gas, baby, gas. Okay. Alrighty. Going for a depth, then I will go Phoenix. I will kill him.
We require more minerals. We need more money.
It shall be done.
Mine more minerals. That is the power field. Inside the blue circle.
Straight in the main. Harass a little bit. Jesus, he doesn't have anything. Nidus, really? You think? There we go.
You need more minerals. In my day.
actually he did it. GG. Actually, I got schooled here, guys. Devise some other strategy how to counter the Ling aggression. I didn't make any units. That was a start. Okay, now I'm playing. I'm fucking serious, man.
The shit is real.
Let's get him. He doesn't see. Thank you. Actually, we can kill the music. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with another game between gLiM and Scorpion, if you have followed this series. I don't know, bro. I don't know if this map is a complete cancer. I don't know. It's tricky. It's a tricky map. So basically, you have to do some kind of tricky things to be able to survive the tricky map. Because I saw a guy actually mine those two patches, expand over here, and everything is good. So he used this guy to mine, and he mined this and this, and he expanded here, pretty on the safe side. The other guy saw that there was no base here and he flipped out. So, you know, it's difficult. Okie dokie, we are checking out a couple of overlords are moving. They're high-fiving in the air, tentacles and stuff. Let's zoom out a little bit. And so, actually it's pretty even right about now. Both spawning pools are even. The fast expansions are even a tad bit quicker for gLiM. Yeah, one worker quicker. So, and of course a little bit. One worker quicker. Everything was one worker quicker for gLiM. Also, his speed was quicker. And do we have the speed? We gotta see it now. We don't see it. Speed. Okay. Some other kind of shenanigan, probably by Scorpion, is going to do the wall off upgrades and stuff, because this speed is halfway there. The bandling nests are on the way. Man, This guy took me to school the first game with the one base Nidus. I didn't expect it, I had no counter for it. Actually, I scouted it, but I couldn't do anything. I was helpless. Okay, Scorpion finally decides that he will use that gas income and make a speed leak. Why are you running away? Bailing Nest? Some sort of a wall-off we need. Speed is going to kick in for gLiM and Scorpion is going to face the music. But he makes 10 links. His Bailing Nest almost ready. gLiM is already making 4 Bane links right outside the base. What do we have here? We have 5 Bane links in response and a couple of queens. Let's see, is this queen going to do a good head job on the Bane links? 1 goes down, 2 go down, 3 go down, 4, excellent! The queens are doing amazing job. Now, is the queen going to be alive? Oh Jesus, Jesus! Huge explosions. And we are left with not queens. No queens for Scorpion. That's why he's floating minerals and that's why the other guy has a bit more. Because his queen spit on the hatchery. The amazing thing about the Zerg is when the queen spit on the hatchery, actually more larva comes out. And the couple of links will finish the job. Okie dokie. Yeah, that was a smooth game. I don't think. Oh, actually, the workers are even. Okay, I'm baffled. I don't know what is happening. How is this even possible? But we think it is, so I'm seeing it, but I still cannot assimilate it. My mind cannot accept that this is possible. But it is possible, I see it. A Baning explodes, huge damage done. Is the queen going to survive? Of course the queen is going to survive. This is Brenda. The queen that survives is always named Brenda. Some kind of a wall off. Okay, good transition. At least gLiM is consistent in his play. He knows his shit, he knows the game. He's doing the right stuff right away. This is his plus one rush timing. And he droned quite heavily, so he's ahead. Brenda, yes. So, the queen that survives, her name is Brenda. This bitch right here. Let me check. Oh, Jesus, sorry. So, this bitch right here, her name is Brenda. Why? Because I saw a game where a Zerg player barely saved the queen. And when the Zerg player saved the queen, he named her Brenda. So from that time onwards, every queen that survives an engagement is Brenda. And if it is a Terran, we have Jimmy. If it is a Protoss, I don't know, they just don't die. They go somewhere, they get warped back in, so the Protoss is a different story. But the Zerg, this is Brenda for the rest of the game. As long as Brenda is alive, we have a fighting chance. Nothing is lost. But if Brenda dies, you know, I mean, the whole world crumbles. Okie dokie. Do we have a third base from Scorpion? He's trying to catch up on workers, only 11 workers in deficit. This overlord is going to die. 5 roaches in production. We have the speed on the way. Almost ready. This link is going to scout a huge amount of roaches coming. What is Scorpion's response? Can we see 5 spine crawlers? Do we see them? No, we see 8 roaches in production. We have a couple of banes here. 1 zergling. And the casual zergling scout is going to know. Do we have a base? We have the money. We don't have a base. We have 62 out of 100. So overlords to spare. There we go. Some kind of a roach posturing outside the base. So these roaches are posturing outside. Banelings make a huge connection. The red. Oh, that was a good snipe. Did Brenda die? Oh no, this is Brenda. This is Brenda, and she's just walking. She's not fighting. She decides not to fight. It's better not to fight, you know? It's better just to walk around them and intimidate them. So they're scared. Brenda is dead. Oh no, Brenda is alive. Second win for Brenda. And anticlimactic shit. Brenda just died. Okie dokie. Scorpion did actually quite much better compared to his previous games. So... Chichonsky, do you like the answer about Brenda? Okay, GG. ZZ. Gas Starf, of course. Okay, I'm going to end the stream right there, guys. I will probably come back later to play some games. What is this guy's name? Poik. We'll be hosting somebody. Who? Koek is not live, guys. Yeah, Chichonsky, my man. I don't know, dude. So, Koek is not live. So, we will probably host with our 3,000 viewers. We will host Rotterdam. I mean raid. How can I do it? Raid at Rotterdam 08, or maybe without the at. Is this possible? Alrighty. Two viewers are ready to raid Rotterdam. Three viewers are ready to raid Rotterdam. Let's check it out. Raid now. And thank you very much, guys, for this amazing stream.
Support events. Ah, okay. I don't really get what this is, but... Alright. Well, we're at super hard now. I don't know whether it really changes, but I guess it's harder to complete.